Venom Let There Be Carnage is a movie that has been highly anticipated for some time now. And of course, the team and I decided to watch it all and give you all a recap of the movie. But before we do that, Zia has an important message for you guys.
Alright guys, make sure you leave a like, subscribe, hit the notification button, and if you also want more content, comment down below. We always read your comments, so be ready to listen.
Now let's get into the actual video. So the movie starts here in this weird haunted boarding school for unwanted kids. Here you see this guy, you know, just chilling, doing his thing, aka the creep. Now he's talking to this girl right here, also the not-so-pushy girlfriend. And yeah, you know, just they're both crazy, you know, it's two crazy people talking to each other, nothing weird here. So apparently she's gotta go, and like, he doesn't want that, but bro, stop. Hit that window, it's not gonna do anything. It's just stop. He's still batting away at the window, and like, yeah, they just say their emotional last goodbyes and they take her away in this van thingy. So she's stuck in the backseat with P. Mulligan, also known as the cop I won't talk about. And she decides that she doesn't like him and wants to scream him to death. And either by luck or absolute skill, he gets away with his life. I mean, wow, the clutch in these things is just amazing. So now she's in this weird place for mad people called Ravencroft, where she's being constantly watched by this creepy woman who enjoys sending little kids to go feed her through glass. But honestly, that's the face of someone who wants to eat you, man. Get away. I'm right again. So it turns out that this guy, aka Cletus Cassidy, aka the Creep, is about to get his death sentence, but he cannot because nobody knows where he hides all of his bodies. You know, it's very weird. So the FBI call Eddie to try and find out where his stash of human skeletons are, and he's like, bro, I don't want to see that creep. And he's like, I don't care, dude, you're going. So Venom tries to make a meal out of the FBI guy, and Eddie drags him into the bathroom for a pep talk. So he's like, no eating FBI people, dude. And he's like, no, I'm hungry. And then they have this long argument in this bathroom, all the while not realizing they're in the ladies' room. And then he comes and he's like, all right, let's do this.
What do you want, Cletus? I mean, why am I here?
Do a man who's buried alive a kindness. Won't you get a message out to all my fans? And in return, I'll give you my life.
What?
Story. I heard the written word hasn't been working out so well. Piece like this, an exclusive, would put you back on top.
Go on.
People love serial killers.
No, we don't, dude. Just stop killing people, man. It ain't cool.
All my secrets laid bare, Eddie. So much carnage.
Well, why me?
I like you.
Run away, man. Run away. I mean, look at him. Let's be honest. He is not safe, so you should probably just leave.
All right, it's a deal.
Stupid!
So when Eddie finally decides that it's time to leave the creep alone, Venom calls his attention to his personal art gallery. Oh my god, is that blood?
Yes, it is.
So when Eddie and Venom finally get home, Venom decides to use all of the images that he got from that creep's gallery. And he actually finds out where he's been hiding all the skeletons for the past couple of probably decades. Thank you. big brain. So they eventually dug up his extensive skeleton collection. And because of that, they reinstated his death sentence. And trust me, my man ain't happy. You want my honest advice, Eddie Brock? Stay away from that guy. So Venom gets hungry and pressures Eddie to go get him some food. But as there is zero chocolate in the store nearby, they're pressured to go and get raw KFC themselves. On their way back, though, they throw a bad guy into a dumpster and Eddie gets a call from the not-so-beloved ex-fiancé.
Be nice to her.
You sound out of breath. I'm not catching you at a bad time, am I?
No, not at all. I'm just hanging around.
So she invites him to this fancy establishment. And just when we're expecting her to say something sensible or important, this happens.
So?
I don't know. I thought it would be better to tell you in person, but...
Huh?
Okay, let's be really honest. That was rude. There is no reason why you need to invite him to see him in person to tell him this. He does not need to know. So eventually Eddie decides to leave. And honestly, what's the sad face? Look, I don't like you. At all. So Eddie eventually gets himself a letter from Cassidy, apparently inviting him to his death, I guess. And it's also a weird drama life about his previous misdeeds and, you know, all of his weird adventures.
You know, I should be there.
No, it's a bad idea.
I mean, I put him there.
Actually, he put himself there when he decided to be a complete lunatic. Ta-da!
You know, it would be nice just to have your support. Just for once.
Catch up!
Eddie being Eddie eventually goes anyway. Let's just be really honest here. I don't think a guy that you just put back on death row wants to talk to you. I mean, really? I see this going so wrong already.
Stand like that, I dare you!
Haha, I told ya, boy. So when Venom and Eddie finally get home, they have a very heated adult conversation.
You son of a bitch!
Ooh, that was a slap. So they have this long bro fight, and then eventually Venom dips. And honestly, I think he's gone. While all that is happening, it's time for Cletus Cassidy to die. And, of course, it being a movie, they botch it up. He eventually breaks out of containment, throws a few guys around like ragdolls, and breaks out of there in grand style. So while all this is happening, Venom's at the party of his life. And, of course, the creep is on another killing spree. I mean, seriously. You have serious issues. So Eddie goes hunting for Cletus and his girlfriend and finds a very important clue back at the haunted madhouse and tells his friend at the FBI. But of course, the cop I won't talk about throws his clue right out the window. Cletus eventually finds out where his not-so-pishy girlfriend is located and breaks her out of there in pretty grand style. And, of course, someone's got to take the fall for it. Thus, Eddie is being questioned by the FBI once again. And since he's kind of useless without Venom, he requests his presence in his time of plight.
He said he didn't need him. That life was better without him.
Okay, I don't understand. What do you care? Oh, wait a second. You get out here right now!
Ew! That's so disgusting.
Moving on. Venom breaks Eddie out of custody. They both make peace. And they both go and try to find the creep and the not-so-pushy girlfriend. But not before they make away with the cop I won't talk about and the not-so-beloved fiancé, and go to get united in rather unholy matrimony.
What is that? Why does she look like that? Oh my god, it's not even the traditional white dress, it's a black dress. She looks like something that they conjured from hell. Why is she wearing black? Who does this?
Back to the story. Venom and Eddie break the wedding, and Carnage comes out about his very interesting ancestry.
Death to you, father.
No!
Not you, father. You, father.
So Venom shrinks back in fear and tells Eddie about the unlikely results of this endeavor. And after that, Venom and Eddie proceed to save the rather unloved fiancé. Venom settles his family issues by making a meal out of his son and buying this guy's head off.
You in there, get him out of here. They're gonna come for you both.
Alright. Let's be honest. I get you're trying to help, but that doesn't change the fact that I don't like you.
Monsters.
Weird. Anyway, so at the end of the movie, Eddie and Venom are like in this weird like beach, I don't even know, a tropical place. And then you'll never guess whose face we see on the screen.
He's a spider menace. But rest assured, dear viewers, we here at the Daily Bugle will not rest until we've uncovered the
guy.
Well alive. I'm Jacob.
I mean, if any of you guys know exactly what that last part meant, please do leave an explanation in the comments section. But until then, I guess I'll see you in the next video.